a good time now. Welcome to paradise. Paradise. Paradise.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you are new and you're interested in what I am talking about, please like, share, and subscribe and leave a comment below if you have any questions or if you even have any advice. I look at all of my comments and I try to respond to all of them as well. So let's get started. Basically, it is my 1 year anniversary for my plastic surgery. Well, it's not quite the actual date. Honestly, my date was changed and I honestly kind of can't remember my exact date. I think it was like February 15th, I think. I'm not sure, because I think it was like the 11th at first, and then because of my complications with my blood pressure, I was not able to get it on that day. So I don't know, it's all kind of like a blur right now. But basically, yes, this is 1 year, and I promised you guys that I would give you guys a 1 year update, and this is it. So I'm definitely going to show you guys my body and what it looks like right now. I have not eaten yet. It's probably about 1:30 in the afternoon. And I've kind of been doing intermittent fasting. And that's kind of been helping somewhat. So I am very, very empty. I've only been drinking water today and that's it. So you guys will see exactly what I look like with no food in my stomach and just, yeah, like what it looks like. And I might show you guys to a video what it looks like after you have eaten versus when you haven't eaten, because it is a big difference. What's the word? There's still no feeling in the front of my stomach. When I'm sitting, it's weird, like you can kind of feel like your incision, like when you're sitting down and you're kind of like moving like front, like moving like this, you know, like your stomach kind of like, or like it like tilts, like your pelvis area, like you can kind of like feel, and maybe that's just the skin kind of folding on itself, but I don't know, like you can kind of feel that. Which I never could feel that before, so it's just something that I've noticed, and it's not anything that's like a big deal, but just like I said, something that I've noticed. What else? I do occasionally, I mean, this is really, really like rare, but I do still occasionally get slight zinging in the lipo areas on my back, but it's like rare and it's like really, really slight. What else? The skin is still pretty loose in my opinion, but like I said before, Duran did tell me that I had that my skin quality wasn't very well, I mean, you know, wasn't very good, so I kind of expected my skin not to be like, you know, very, very taut, but you know, it is what it is. And I think to get that remedied, I think you'd have to get like a tummy tuck, like a second tummy tuck and muscle repair, and I don't think I'm gonna do that again. Like there, yeah, like I'm more than likely I would not do that again. It's just, I just wouldn't want to go through like the exact same process all over again, so that's definitely out of the question for me. But you know, to each his own. I have been looking around at surgeons. I still have not really found one that I feel, I don't know, that I guess I strongly feel like, you know, yeah, this is the one. A lot of the surgeons' prices have gone up, I've noticed, like quite a bit actually, just in 1 year. So that's just, you know, a tidbit of information so that you guys know. What else? Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. well, I shouldn't say that's it. Like, even though, like, my surgery, I mean, it looks good, but there are still areas that I do want to improve and want to show you guys my body. Like, my arms are definitely one. I mean, they're just not good. And, you know, like, there's the whole, like, look of when you get the surgery, like, when your arms are really big, you just kind of look like a football player. Like, you have this tiny waist and you have these, like, big arms, and I don't know, it looks weird. But yeah, so that's definitely, like, a main concern is my arms. My thighs have gotten a lot thicker, which some people probably would think, oh, that's a great thing. I really don't want my thighs to be this thick. I like thigh gap. And yeah, so I would actually really like to get lipo in the middle of my thighs. I mean, you know, like in my inner thighs. I probably need like an arm lift. I would love for this to just be lipo and that be good enough. But I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. I feel like this probably would need a lift, which I would hate to have to get, but might be necessary. And as you all know, I would love to get my chin snatched. I would love that. But I know that I couldn't get all of those procedures at one time, because when I do eventually go back for my second round, I definitely still want to get lipo in my midsection area. Even though I don't really know what they could find. Like, I think it's just skin that I have, but I don't know. If they could find any fat, then by all means, yeah, just snatch it out. So, and I also would like a second BBL just to round it out and kind of heart shape it more. Like, I feel like it's too shelfy, and I really did not want a shelf, but like, that was completely not what I wanted, but I feel like that's what I got. And yeah, like, I would love for it to slope. I think that would be like the ultimate of what I want. So yeah, like, hopefully that could happen eventually, you know, when I get my second round. And then I'll, you know, like I told you guys before, I would definitely film or document the process of getting the second round. Like I said, so far I just really haven't, I just been getting quotes so far, and I have not gone through a coordinator this time. I've kind of just been contacting the doctors myself. I did get another quote from Duran, but I also included the arm lift in these quotes, so that's gonna really change the price up a lot. I realized that the arm lift costs like probably about $25,000 to $3,000 just for the arm lift. So that's gonna increase the price like a lot. So I wanna say she quoted me like $7,800. I think it was like $7,800 for, you know, lipo, BBL, and arm lift. That was $7,800. So to me, that was like a lot, because before it was like, I think my quote was 50, it was either 5,600 or 5,700. And so, I don't know. It's just, and I know this with all the doctors, it goes up a lot with the arm lift. So, hopefully I don't need an arm lift. I don't know, guys. Help me out with this. But we'll see. And basically, that's it. So, like, I'm gonna just show you guys what I look like now, and yeah. Okay guys, so here I'm doing a little spin around, little turn for you guys to see all the angles. And then this is for those of you who want to see what the scars look like. You can see what my stomach looks like without having anything on it. And like I said before, I have not eaten anything, so it
is pretty flat right now. Oops, I don't want to show you guys too much. So yeah, that's how far back my scars go with the tummy tuck incision. And that is my faja burn, which I hate. But yeah, so, and here's my arms. I mean, they look pretty flabby to me, but let me know what you guys think. I think they definitely probably need a lift. So I'm just showing you guys, like, I wanted to see my rib cage, but you can't really see it that well. And there's some definition, like some lines in my stomach, so I wanted to show you guys that as well.
So that is my body. Let me know what you guys think, whether it's good or bad. It doesn't matter to me because, I mean, it is what it is. I have, like I said, been trying to intermittent fast. I have not been working out. I was working out, and then it was almost like my situation went in reverse. Like most people work out when the new year starts, I kind of like stopped working out when the new year started. So yeah, but I do need to get back on track with that. My blood pressure is still high. My doctor's like, work out, drink more water. And that's one thing that I really wasn't doing. I realized I really was not drinking any water. Like, I drink LaCroix, and you know, like I'll have like maybe 2, 3, 4 cans of those like a day, and that's like it. That was like all the fluid that I was really consuming. Like, I wasn't drinking any flat water. So lately I have been trying to drink at least maybe 3/4 of one of these a day. That's been really, really tough, but hopefully in time, with, you know, maybe some, once I start exercising again, which I'm actually going to try to do today since it is a Monday and the start of a new week, I need to get in gear for that. And you guys, next week I'll be going to Vegas, and I would love to show you guys my trip. So I'm gonna try to vlog it and upload that as well. And so far I'm just gonna prepare to look as cute as I can for my little outfits for Vegas. And yeah, so if you guys like this video, and if you guys found it informative, please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys all in the next video. Bye.